everyone. Welcome to Sri Chaitanya. This is Umashankar, All India IIT Coordinator. Welcome to JEE Max Season Number 2. Through this season, we are completely concentrating on a particular topic which is very, very important for both the JEE Mains, Advanced, and of course, Board Examinations also. Of the complex numbers is one, and we are end of the complex numbers, that is the demo, is there. We are concentrating through these lessons. And my friends, please don't forget to check the description there. I am providing all the links of the previous videos also. And if possible, sometimes some of the good examinations, papers, and assignments along this video. And now, through this lesson, we are concentrating on solving the problems from exercise 5.2 of ICON Integrated Textbook. Because if you mastered all the problems, including the workload example from the Integrated Textbook, that knowledge is more than sufficient to crack the best in JEE Mains and Advanced. Today, through this lesson, we are solving problems 10 to 13. Even in a previous video 56, we have completed some of this kind of models, and in continuation to that, the problem number 13 and 10 to 13 problems will take place. Now, this is the question. If cos alpha plus cos beta plus cos gamma equal to 0, sin alpha plus sin beta plus sin gamma equal to, you have to show. See, actually, if you are applying the transformations, but if you are following the things with the help of the trigonometry only, with the trigonometric compound angles, to get the proofs, it becomes very difficult for you. But try to understand the idea behind the concepts. Here, I would like to give some of the hints for you. See the hint. Actually, this is given for you. Let A, you say cos alpha plus I sin alpha, B, cos beta plus I sin beta, C, cos gamma plus I sin gamma. So, since cos alpha plus cos beta plus cos gamma equal to 0 equal to sin alpha plus sin beta plus sin gamma equal to 0, therefore A plus B plus C equal to 0. Whenever A plus B plus C equal to 0, automatically A cube plus B cube plus C cube is equal to 3ABC. Several times I have mentioned this point. Now what I am doing is divide on both sides with 3ABC. So I got this result. So A square by BC plus B square by AC or CA plus C square by AB equal to 3. A square means, I think A is what? Cos alpha plus I sin alpha. A square means sis 2 alpha. By BC means sis beta plus gamma. Sigma I can take equal to 3. If I have expanded it, you will get the same. And sis alpha by sis beta is the sis alpha minus beta. So this implies sigma sis of 2 alpha minus beta minus gamma equal to 3. So what is sis of 2 alpha plus minus 2 beta minus gamma equal to 3? That is cos of 2 alpha minus beta minus gamma plus I sin of 2 alpha minus beta minus gamma plus cos of 2 beta minus gamma minus alpha plus I sin of 2 beta minus gamma minus alpha plus cos of 2 gamma minus alpha minus beta plus I sin of 2 gamma minus alpha minus beta equal to 3, which is in a RHS side, that I can write it as a 3 plus I 0. Now you equate real and imaginary part. If you have equated the real part, answer is this one. And if you have equated the imaginary part, answer is this one. Please don't get any confusion. Cos terms gives answer as 3, whereas for sine terms, you will get answer as 0 only. Okay. Now, coming to 11th problem. See the statement properly. The small difference is there. When compared with the 10th problem and 11th problem, you have observed one small difference. There in the 10th problem, what is given? Cos alpha plus cos beta plus cos gamma equal to 0 equal to sin alpha plus sin beta plus sin gamma equal to 0. That is given for you. Whereas here, cos alpha plus 2 cos beta plus 3 cos gamma and sin alpha plus 2 sin beta plus 2 sin 3 sin gamma equal to 0 is given. So with the help of this, we may expect the result by looking the given the proven quantity. You will get an immediately an idea that okay. As usual, just like in the previous problem, I am taking my A as cos alpha plus cos beta plus cos gamma, B as cos beta plus I sin beta, C as what? Cos gamma plus I sin gamma. then cos 2 alpha plus 2, since cos 2 alpha plus 2 cos beta plus 3 cos gamma equal to sin alpha plus 2 sin beta plus 3 sin gamma equal to 0, therefore a plus 3b plus 2b plus 3c equal to 0. What is so whenever a plus b plus c equal to 0, a cube plus b cube plus c cube is equal to 3abc. So what is eq? That is cis 3 alpha, because this is a cis alpha whole cube, that is cis 3 alpha plus 8 into what is b cube? Cis 3 beta plus 27. What is CQ? Cis 3 gamma equal to 18 into what is ABC? Cis alpha into cis beta into cis gamma. That is cis alpha plus beta plus gamma. Now equate the real and imaginary parts. Of course, if you have equated the real part, there you will get cos 3 alpha plus 8 cos 3 beta plus 27 cos 3 gamma equal to 18 cos of alpha plus beta plus gamma. Similarly, if you have equated the imaginary part, you will get the required result. This is about the 11th problem. Now, coming to the 12th problem, it is a little bit tricky because last two parts are very easy for you, whereas the first part is a little bit tricky because it is simple. There, in a cos and cos angle, cos 2 power n alpha is given and cos 2 power n beta is given, cos 2 power n gamma is given. So how to get that term? Ultimately, that is what? Real part. So how to get that term with the help of cos alpha plus cos beta plus cos gamma equal to 0 equal to sin alpha plus sin beta plus sin gamma? If you notice that point, then by equating the real and imaginary parts, you will get the result very easily. For that, see the hint here. As usual, I have considered my A as cos alpha plus I sin alpha, my B as cos beta plus I sin beta, my C as cos gamma plus I sin gamma. And of course, A plus B plus C equal to 0 implies 1 by A plus 1 by B plus 1 by C equal to 0. That's all. So, trivial. And if I have taken common, I mean LCM, that means AB plus BC plus CA equal to 0. But we know that A plus B plus C whole square is equal to A square plus B square plus C square plus 2 into AB plus BC plus CA. With the help of these, since a plus b plus c equal to 0 and a b plus b c plus c a equal to 0, I got what? A square plus b square plus c square equal to 0. So what I got? I got a square plus b square plus c square equal to 0. Whenever a plus b plus c equal to 0, then 1 by a plus 1 by b plus 1 by c equal to 0. With the help of that, I got what? So see, whenever a plus b plus c equal to 0, that implies 1 by a plus 1 by b plus 1 by c equal to 0. And with the help of this, I got a square plus b square plus c square equal to 0. Similarly, whenever a square plus b square plus c square equal to 0, then automatically 1 by a square plus 1 by b square plus 1 by c square equal to 0. Just like. So with the help of this, I may get a power 4 plus b power 4 plus c power 4 equal to 0. That I can write it as conveniently a power 2 square plus b power 2 square plus c power 2 square equal to 0. If I am continuing this on the same line, I may get a power 2n 2 power n plus b power 2 power n plus c power 2 power n equal to 0. This is the crucial step here. One should appreciate and one should practice. Now, the story, now ball is in your court. Because what is a power 2 power a power 2 power n? That is nothing but cis 2 power n alpha plus cis 2 power n beta plus cis 2 power n gamma equal to 0. Now equate real and imaginary parts on both sides. Equate real and imaginary parts on both sides. What is the real part? Cos 2 power n alpha plus cos 2 power n beta plus cos 2 power n gamma equal to 0. Similarly, if you are equating the imaginary part, there you will get, of course, they are not asked the question, but even then, sometimes they may ask. So, practice this. Sin 2 power n beta plus sin 2 power n gamma equal to 0. That's all about the first part. Now, coming to the second, is very easy. How to get alpha plus beta? How to get beta plus gamma? That is important. That's very trivial. Because whenever a plus b plus c equal to 0, automatically ab plus bc plus ca equal to 0. What is ab plus bc plus ca? That is cis alpha plus beta plus cis beta plus gamma plus cis gamma plus alpha equal to 0. Now equate again a real and imaginary part. That implies cos of alpha plus beta plus cos of beta plus gamma plus cos of gamma plus alpha equal to 0. Similarly, sin of alpha plus beta plus sin of beta plus gamma plus sin of gamma plus alpha equal to 0. So that is about problem number 2 and 3. My friends, these are all are the similar versions, but everything takes place with the simple algebraic manipulations, which are very, very famous and well known for you. See, this part I have mentioned here. From hint 1, 2, and 3, if a plus b plus c equal to 0, automatically a b plus b c plus c a equal to 0. That implies sigma cis alpha plus beta equal to 0. Equate real and imaginary parts. Equate real and imaginary parts. Then you will get the answer. Okay, I think hope you like this video. If you like this, please share and subscribe my channel, and please don't forget to check the this press the bell icon, and you will get the continuous notification, and we will meet with the next